Alright, open 7-6 suited, get called. Go for a c-bet here. Couple backdoors with some overcards. Interesting turn card. They pick up the flush draw and the pair. I think we can bet again. If we get raised here, we would get to continue to call. Just checking back to realize our equity okay. It's nice to build a pot though if he has like some ace high. I might bluff some rivers even though like our specific hand might seem like a bad one to do it with. Now he does raise, so we're just gonna call. Obviously I wish the board wasn't paired at this point, but we'll call. And river nine. If they check here, I'm probably gonna bluff river. Hoping they were doing something out of line with like an ace high or something. Not a great hand to bluff, but we'll go for it. And we see the snap fold, 7-6 gets through. Not sure on the size there if I needed to pot it or maybe like half pot or three quarters is better. I think once they raise, when we bet, we're probably pretty polar. I think we can go bigger. I think we'll click it. Calls. Good flop here is like basically pot behind. We don't see the ace. Gonna go ahead and bet small. Can maybe go a bit bigger, but with the SPR what it's at, I think we can go pretty small on this kind of board. Jack turn. At this point, we're just going to be jamming. Calls. Queen 3. It'll hold there with kings. Nice pot. Hijack opens off about 40 blinds. We 3-bet. They call. Queen Jack 6. Start with a small bet here. And if they decide to check jam, obviously call. Aces versus pocket fours. And ace is good. Nice. Prop 3 says I see a lot of short stacks at 2-5 level on your streams. Yeah, I'm actually kind of surprised by how many people short stack as well. Here we open eights. This player is going to jam in about 17 blinds. We'll call with eights. They have sevens. Perfect spot. Just got to hold. And a good run out there with eights. Aces again. Man, I've had aces a lot at 2-5 today. I haven't had many pots with them, but button open, 3-bet aces, big blind cold calls. See another call. King and Jack 3. So I'm going to take a check line here. This is kind of exploit, hoping this guy is just going to jam a lot, and then dank behind here would call with any King X. And then we cover. If he flats here, we're going to rejam. So I think when I check here, he might think they were doing a lot of folding, so he's more or less just trying to figure out he's good there. So obviously call is played. Has the spade draw, we got a fade. So we lose versus the king eight. Unfortunately, they turn two pair, but we win a side pot versus the ace four suited. Unlucky turn card, but still make some money on it. Button opens here, we 3-bet tens, get snap called. 7-6-2. We're gonna go big here, snap call, five turn. Just over pot behind, we're gonna jam it in here with the overpair. Get snapped off, has ace seven, and we hold, nice pot with tens. All right, hijack opens here, defend queen jack, check on 10-6-3. Turn top pair, we're gonna go ahead and check. We could lead out this as well. I wanna make sure I'm mixing some checks with like jack x here. It's a fun one to do it with. We're not susceptible to a ton of runouts having a diamond and an overcard. So he bets, we'll call. And river two pair check. Now ace king comes in. I'm actually curious if I get to check raise this or not. Probably depends on size. Versus overbet. Gosh, man, this is just so sick. He has us beat. Oh, he just has the straight. It's so tilting. Like, I just want to fold these rivers, but it's like, how in the world do I ever fold there having top two with a diamond? He overbets, even if I just, like, don't think there's a ton of bluffs there. Cut off open, through betting ace-king. See the call. King-queen-10, kind of interesting one here. We're going to go ahead and check top pair, top kicker. That's 45, we'll just check call. Four on the turn, check. Bets again, kind of a weird one. I think I'm going to jam here, make him stack off with like his queen jack, king jack, pocket jacks. I mean, it feels like sometimes it's hard to get called by worse here, but I think we'll get it in. We get snapped and they have, like, he's definitely going to have two pair here, which is a problem. Some sets. Ugh. Wow, we got there though. So I get an inverse queens. I'm going to want to check the turn there with ace king. I think that was okay with how much money's behind. Like, obviously, if we're a lot deeper, we really don't like that. I maybe have a hand that can just call. I'm not sure. But I want to take a look at it. Obviously, get super lucky on the river. We tried it out. Here, we're going to open nines over a limper, get called. We flop top set. Start with a bet here. Get raised. So this board is so much action. I think I'm just going to get this in here. We beat sets of eights and sixes. If he has 10-7, we just got to get there. But his diamond draws and stuff are in a call. So on this wet of a board, I think I just get this in versus this player. Wow, he had 10-7 with the flush draw. It's so ridiculous. Oh my gosh. I mean, I figured he's probably pretty strong, but we literally lose the 10-7 only. And yeah, just get stacked in the single raise pot there. That's annoying. Here we open small blind, big blind, three bets. Because we're super deep, I end up just flatting here. We flop top two. All seven of diamonds turn. Interesting card. Maybe could do some leading here to side against it. That's huge. We're going to call one more. Ten river check. So king jack comes in. Obviously lose the diamonds. I don't know if he has a ton of 7x. Please don't jam. Jesus. Probably just going to make a tight fold here. This is really annoying, blind versus blind. But if he triple barrels, I mean, it's really... Like I said, the 10 is relevant because king jack comes in. Lose the flushes. We don't have a diamond blocker. Let it go. Pretty sad to throw that pot to pull top pair, top kicker. But that turn card was really bad. All right, open 10s. Small blind flat. Big blind squeeze. We're just going to flat here in position. Nine, five, four. Bet 75. I think we're just going to call. Kind of want to jam. Let's see. 300. I think we're slightly too deep to jam. Problem, though. There's so many bad turns. Bet's 147. Let's see. We have tens, no diamonds. Just gonna fold. I don't know if I like it. Here we open queen nine suited, get two calls. We're gonna flop the straight. I'm gonna try to go for check raise here. I think this is a board we can check a lot multi-way. We unblocked a lot of their continues. Go for the raise. Seven turn. Obviously going to kill a lot of the action. I think if I want to check jam this, maybe. I think I'm going to go for check jam. The double check raise. So I think a lot of times he'll blast his club draws, diamond draws here. And if he has a nine here, he's never going to fold. Damn, obviously call. Has jack eight of diamonds. Whew. Fade the diamond and the queen nine holds. Love to see it. All right, YouTube, that wraps up our 5-hour cash game session here. And in the 2-5 game, 543 hands, profit of 593. In the 1-2 game, 1,531 hands, loss of $1,323. Total loss on day, minus 729. You guys didn't see the 1-2 hands, as you can tell by the results, though. Pretty miserable day at 1-2. It felt like I got absolutely crushed. We lost 729 today, which isn't good, but as far as like how many buy-ins and stuff we lost, it feels like we got crushed way worse than we did dollar-wise. So hope you at least enjoyed the video and the hands today. If you did, please remember to like, comment, and subscribe. And if you ever want to watch the live streams on Twitch, I have a link to my Twitch channel in the description below.